Anybody who believes anything other than this is all my responsibility, that I can change and get a different result. If you believe anything other than that, you're never going to reach your full potential. What are your goals? The only thing that you should believe or do is that which moves you towards your goals. So if lamenting and feeling broken inside because I was victimized by somebody is going to move me forward, then I will do it. But my gut is that'll take me to a dark place. It won't put me in a position to think and act and try to be strategic and make more useful decisions in the future. Rather than the problem is overwhelming, this problem is solvable. If people always start with that, this problem is solvable. Now we may disagree about how to solve the problem, but we're at least in the right frame of mind. There's not the hopelessness. There's not the, this is forever, we're stuck. It's, what can I do? How do I improve? How do I get myself out of this? People have been given sort of a general sense of how to think culturally that I don't think moves people towards their individual goals. And I just know that fulfillment requires you to do something hard. To build yourself, to become stronger, to become more resilient, to have meaning and purpose. We are hardwired to experience joy when we have meaning and purpose, and that we had to work hard for a set of skills that allow us to serve other people. It is innate. You'll never be able to get somebody to not feel good about that. So if we know that's an innate path, get people on that path, right? Know what your goal is, and then do and believe things and move people towards that goal. Where the other thing, to be cynical, to be pissed about what somebody else had, it's a dark place, man.
Transform yourself into something that is truly undeniable, to become so good that they can't ignore you. The reason that we have taken over the globe in a way that no other species has is because we are the ultimate adaptation machine. Darwin is often misquoted as saying it's the strongest of the species that survived. He did not say that. What he said was it's neither the strongest of the species that survived nor the most intelligent, but rather the most adaptive to change. It is the animal that can change the fastest to a changing environment that becomes the most dominant species the world has ever seen. It is our very nature to change. That is what we are wired to do. If you look at human DNA, we have roughly 20,000 genes that encode traits. And for a long time, scientists disregarded all of the other, what they call junk DNA, that didn't encode for traits. But what we now know that junk DNA is epigenetic signaling. It is the thing that makes us extraordinary. It's the thing that says, in this environment, respond like this. So you can go to the gym and bust your ass and train your body and change your physique. And we've all seen it happen with bodybuilders. We all get that they came out of the womb weak, just like everybody else. And they put themselves under an ungodly amount of stress and strain. And they push themselves every day. And they had this just unimaginable amount of discipline. And from that, they are able to transform themselves into somebody completely unrecognizable. It is amazing. And because it happens on the outside, we all get it. We all believe in it. We look at athletes and we understand that they work their way there. But we don't look at Garry Kasparov and realize he did the same thing. Because what's happening in the mind seems invisible. We can't see it. We don't understand what's happening. What you build your self-esteem around matters. And whether you realize it or not, each and every one of you has something that sits at the core of how you feel about yourself. And from that, your identity, your sense of self-worth, your self-esteem, it is all built around that thing. Because you cannot make change until you acknowledge where you're actually at. If you understand where you're weak, then you know where to spend your time building skills. To me, the gap between where you are now and where you want to go is a gap of skill set. As Nassim Taleb says, things that are robust, that are strong, that are tough, that can take just a lot of abuse before they break, they are still ultimately defined by their breaking point. Something that is anti-fragile, on the other hand, is something that the more you attack it, the more it is pounded on, the stronger it gets.